What is up, guys? My name is Prestige. Welcome to episode 2 of 5 Things You Probably Didn't Know About Infinite Warfare. If you guys missed the first episode, it will be all together in this playlist linked down below. But if you guys learned something new in this video, or if you just want to show that same support, by all means, make sure to click that like button down below, and don't forget to subscribe for more episodes coming very soon. Without further ado, let's get right into it. Starting with that number 5 spot, we have the De-atomizer strike. Of course, this is a 25 kill streak that is attached to specific weapons out there, and I wanted to see if there was a way to cancel this thing from coming into the map and completely demolishing everything. I figured our best bet was to use the Centurion payload, which comes attached on the striker rig. Now, this creates a small EMP blast, and I figured it would stop the nuke, but for those of you out there that were curious, it doesn't, and as of right now, I don't know any discernible way to take out the de-atomizer strike, and I think that this is something that you can't take out anyway, so we'll just leave it at that. But it was while testing this that I discovered that the Centurion can actually kill you. Did you guys know that? I actually didn't know that, but the Centurion creates this area of effect, and it like hits you like a shock charge. It doesn't slow you down, it doesn't stop your movement, but what it does do is damage you slowly over time. It takes upwards to 30 hits before you're actually killed, but if you're weak enough and you happen to run past this thing, it can definitely drop you, and I had no idea that that was an actual thing, so I wanted to start this episode off with that. Taking that number 4 spot, we have the Dome Shield. Now, this is something that I learned in the developer's handbook for Infinite Warfare, and I thought it was a really cool tip, so I wanted to share it with you guys because it's something I didn't know. But normally, when you throw equipment and things of the like at the Dome Shield, it will bounce off and kinda end there. But did you guys know if you throw down a Seeker grenade, it can actually walk through the barrier and kill anybody that's inside of the Dome Shield? That's something that I didn't know, and it's really gonna come in handy, especially when clearing flags on a game mode like Domination. Another thing you probably didn't know about the Seeker is that early on in development, this thing actually didn't seek out enemies. Instead, where you would throw it is where it would explode. And if there were no enemies within its explosive radius, the Seeker drone would run back to its user, where then you could throw it again. It wouldn't detonate, it would just be ready to be thrown again. I think that's pretty cool, I like the idea behind it, but then again, I could see where the trouble would lie. Taking that number 3 spot, we have the black hole projector, and there are a couple different things I want to talk about. First one is, if there are enemies behind the dome shield, you can forcibly suck them out of that dome shield. As long as they're within the center of it and just being kind of protected by it, you can suck them out of it and kill them. Secondly, you can completely avoid the black hole projector if you go prone, and this means you can be as close as you want to it, you could be completely under it, and you won't get sucked in and you won't get damaged. I find this extremely strange, but at the same time, I understand that this particular piece of equipment needs a counter. There is one more thing that I wanted to test in regard to black holes, and that is the gravity vortex gun that the Striker rig has as its payload. The same exact thing applies to this weapon, believe it or not. If you're laying prone, you won't get sucked into it. But if you're still within the vicinity and you see that red danger symbol up on your screen, you're still going to die because of the small explosion that's left behind as the black hole dissipates. It's still going to kill you no matter how far away you are. As long as that red danger sign is on your screen, you're dead. And just showing you here, even with flak jacket on, it still takes you out from a pretty far distance. Another fun fact about the black hole projector, originally it was not even a projector, it was just a straight up black hole. And then when the projector was added, you were able to actually attach this thing to walls and ceilings, and that created a lot of problems, so the developers made it only available to use on the ground. Taking that number 2 spot, we have the Merc rig, and of course, the reactive armor payload. Did you guys know that you can actually survive a shot from the eraser while using the reactive armor? Taking it even further on the damage spectrum, you can even survive a shot from the Ballista EM3. This is the sniper that targets you and tracks where the bullets are gonna go on your body. It fires 3 extremely powerful sniper shots at you, and you can survive a shot from that. that is crazy, because by the time the person's ready to come up with another shot from the ballista, if you had that reactive armor on, you have definitely enough time to take out the person that's firing at you. And I find that absolutely crazy. Now finally, taking that number one spot, we're talking about the Nano Shot. For those of you that don't know, this is a piece of equipment that's unlocked at level 55. And what it allows you to do is inject yourself to allow you to rapidly regenerate your health. Now with the previous video that I made, a lot of people were calling me an idiot for using this thing before going into battle. And a lot of people were saying that it doesn't work that way. In order to use it, you need to already be injured. But did you guys know that you don't need to be injured in order to use it? As long as you have that green flashing effect on your HUD, you're gonna be rapidly regenerating health. So for the sake of showing you guys how this works, I went ahead and injected myself first, then had my friend JP go ahead and shoot me. As you can see, you can survive significantly longer as long as you have that rapid regen going on. It took over 20 bullets in order to take me out while I had two of these nano shots active in my equipment slot. Now, for those of you that were curious, this isn't what it's going to be like in a real battle situation. Obviously, people are going to be firing the weapon fully automatic at you. You're not going to have as much time to regenerate your health. This was for the sake of showing you guys that even if you use it before you're damaged, you're still able to regenerate health. And this is great for people that are using shotguns or want to get in close quarters with maybe a combat knife. But anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this episode of 5 Things You Probably Didn't Know, make sure to click the like button down below to show your support, subscribe for more awesome episodes coming up very soon, and check out the playlist on your screen right now if you want to see the first episode. By the way, guys, if you are subscribed to the channel and you haven't yet, make sure to activate that notification button and stay up to date on when I upload. Until tomorrow, guys, I will see ya. Peace.